He got fucked on OnlyFans, monetized off of it, and then hid it and pretended to be a retard to get fame. And now he's brave because he got exposed for it?
Oh my fucking God. Bitch, how many back shots he took in these? Be honest. How many bodies did these two see?
So just recently, a very famous Twitch streamer called Sketch, who has been involved in some very crazy drama. And in case you don't know who Sketch is, well, he became famous on Twitch basically just acting like he had autism. So what happened was there was some really crazy rumors going around yesterday that he had a gay OnlyFans from like years ago, and yeah, basically today he just confirmed that was true.
That was me. It's okay, though. I will tell you what. Okay. 2 years ago, I did some stuff. I'm sorry if you've seen some of the stuff. You know, I'm a changed person. This is going worse than I thought it was. So 2 years ago, I did not have sexual relations with that man. I'm just kidding. I did. Possibly.
So this actually gets kind of really sad. When he found out his leaks came out, his first decision was to actually just end it all. And it's really sad because imagine your deepest, darkest secret just coming out like that in front of the whole world.
And I have a lot of people to credit. For, I'll be honest, plan A was, and I will say candidly, was to probably probably to call it quits if this ever came out. But some people saved me. Shout out Banks. Shout out my parents. Like, shout out y'all. Like, I fucked up, but I'm changed. That's about it, though. Like, my original plan was, there's two things. One, either be delusional and think it's never gonna come out, or two, what's the plan after? The plan after was not very good. If I was alone and I was at my house, I probably wouldn't be talking to you right now. But, the people at FaZe, Banks, especially, and my friends that I've made over the past couple years came and they saved me.
So Jinxie, another pretty famous Twitch streamer, he came out and supported Sketch. They're pretty good friends.
But, yeah, Sketch will be my friend no matter what, so that's all. Like you, Sketch will be my friend no matter what, so, yeah. And he didn't hurt anybody, so maybe don't hurt him, because he didn't hurt anybody. Oh, fuck. And W Banks, yet again. Because seriously, I'm not fucking trolling, you never know. You really do never know. And this genuinely could have saved Sketch's life. So, W fucking Banks. Alright. Fuck, man. Holy fuck. I'm sorry if... I know I didn't stream yesterday. And I'm sorry if I can't do a normal stream today. Just a lot of shit happened. And I never talk about stuff like this, but it's different when it's your friend and it's actually your friend. So, I don't think I can do like a normal stream tonight. I'll definitely do a normal stream tomorrow. I'm sorry, guys. I just doesn't feel right to fucking play video games and act like nothing happened. Tomorrow, I promise.
It's enough to make a grown man cry, and that's okay. You go right ahead, dude.
So almost immediately after all this happened, two clout chasing clown streamers just came out and just said the most controversial thing possible because they just wanted attention. So the first one is Sneako. He's notoriously known as an idiot.
Yo, just the craziest thing about Sketch is I'm seeing everyone's like, Sketch is one of the most genuine dudes ever. He's genuinely, I don't know why it's the new Twitch word, he's genuinely one of the most genuine guys ever. Nigga, no, he wasn't. No, he's not. He lied to you about his life. You're acting like it was like a long... 2 years ago, he was taking it up the ass and getting paid for it on OnlyFans. One of those genuine guys that he would have been straight up about his life. What a crazy thing to keep secret. It was 2 years ago.
So because he did something 2 years ago is that he thought that was embarrassing and shameful, and not deciding to tell his audience about it, which most of them are kids, it would be a very weird thing to bring up. So this just makes him not genuine. I don't agree with this at all.
2 years ago, 5 years ago, I talked about like regrettably going to a swinger party and made jokes about it. To this day, they still bring it up. They're like, fuck, Sneako. And then Sketch gets exposed for like being a gay OnlyFans porn star. It's in the past. Let it go. You're a hero. You're so brave. What the fuck did he do that's brave? What did he do? He got fucked on OnlyFans, monetized off of it, and then hid it and pretended to be a retard to get fame. And now he's brave because he got exposed for it? What the fuck happened? What?
Like, just in case people forgot who Sneako was, here's just a quick reminder. He is a cuck. He watches his girlfriend getting fucked. Like, I don't know why he's getting so heated for it. Like, I'm pretty sure if Sketch had a straight OnlyFans that he hid in the past, no one would really even react to it.
One of the most genuine, brave heroes. Is this Bruce Jenner 2.0? You gonna give him an award? Is he gonna get a Nobel Peace Prize for sucking black dick properly?
I'm so sick of these people! You know? Oh!
The fuck are we talking about? Hero? I saw all these people who have never said a word about Palestine since October 7th, bombed every day. Innocent children, we see it all over the timeline. They all see it. They're on the same Twitter app that we're all on. They see the kids getting bombed every single day. They don't say a word. Sketch takes it up the ass, and everyone says, you're the best person ever. What did he do? What did he do?
Okay, yes, it is very sad what is happening with Palestine right now, but what does it have to do with Sketch having a gay OnlyFans? Like, genuinely. And people that probably aren't talking about it, probably because they don't know much what's happening with Palestine. Sketch was probably a streamer they've watched or known. That's why they're talking about it. Anyways, another streamer also came out called Brucedropemoff. He also basically same thing as Sneako, just looking for clout, saying just ridiculous things.
Okay, yeah. Oh, he's cool. What, he was gonna kill himself because he's gay? Oh, I've heard that one before. I was gonna kill myself because DMs got leaked, bitch. Shut up, nigga. Like, look at how dirty these shoes are, chat. But oh my fucking God. Bitch, how many backshots he took in these? Be honest. How many bodies did these shoes see?
I don't know how to explain it. There needs to be an investigation. Somebody might have slipped something into his drink. Somebody might have done something to him. I have no clue.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. The shoes and the glasses, nigga. Can't imagine how much he needed somebody yesterday. Good ups. We know how much he needed somebody yesterday. But when somebody get exposed for being a fake, nigga.
You're a donut. You're so stupid. Dumb.
What if I would have killed myself? Ain't nobody would have given a fuck.
Imagine telling someone to shut up because they're gay. And just making it a white thing for no reason at all. Like, honestly?
To be honest, nigga, shut up and just shake that big black ass.
So everybody that's, oh, yeah, he's still my mans. Of course he's still y'all mans because he bring y'all a fucking paycheck. Y'all gotta save his face. Look how fucking brandable he is. Brandable. Niggas can do sex work. Brandable. You can't say nigga, though. It's not brandable. White folks can get fucked on cam by black dick and go announce a nigga to fucking in the NFL, gang. But a real deal nigga who play Madden all day with the green screen and sweating and shit gets no love. I don't know his name, chat, but I'm fighting for all black creators at this motherfucking point like I've been doing.
But yeah, that's pretty much it. I just think it's very disrespectful and just an asshole thing to do when your deepest secret comes out and two idiots online are just shitting on you for it. I hope Sketch is able to continue his great career and feel like a weight is lifted off his shoulder.